Hello friends, welcome to Wisdom Jobs. I'm Sri Priya. Let us see today's job notification details from West Bengal. So friends, West Bengal Municipal Service Commission is inviting for the recruitment of 2020 with 25 number of vacancies. So before getting into other details of this notification, please subscribe to our channel and don't forget to click bell icon for upcoming notifications. So, getting into the detailed notification, as I said, Municipal Service Commission West Bengal is inviting with 25 number of vacancies. So, this is for the post of field worker as well as general duty attendant. Now, let us see the educational qualification details, important dates as well as how to apply for this application form through the online. So, firstly, getting into the vacancies. So, these vacancies are given according to each post. So, for the post of field worker, that is MHW grade 3, 21 number of vacancies are provided. And for the field worker, SH grade 3, 2 and general duty attendant also 2. And you should have a qualification, that is your educational qualification with 8th class standard certificate or from a recognized or the government recognized school. So it's not mandatory that you should have a 8th class certificate itself. If you are qualifying above 8th standard also, you will be suitable for applying this post. And now coming to the age limit, the minimum age limit is 18 years and maximum age limit is 40 years. So you can have age of 18 or 40 or between any of these ages, but make sure that you should have not have an age below 18 or exceeding above the 40. If not, you will not be suitable for applying this post. And the salary package details is according to the pay level 1 of the pay matrix of ROPA 2019. And there will be a selection procedure for the candidate. So this is based upon written examination then followed by interview. So mostly written examination could be your online examination, which is a computer based system, or an offline examination, which is your pen and paper based system. But whatever the examination, it's according to their perspectives, it could be a negative marking system too. So what is a negative marking system? So if you're making any wrong answer or if you're marking the answer which is not known by you, and you may lose that right answer, like your wrong answer mark from your previous right answer. So gradually your score will be decreases. So, but it's mandatory if you wanted to get into the interview that you should have a higher score. So make sure you'll attempt the questions which are known by you perfectly. Then it could be a not negative marking system also. So if it is for 1 mark and for every question 1 mark will be given. So, and there will be, if you are making any wrong answer, you'll not lose marks. So it depends upon their perspectives and the examination pattern. But whatever the examination, it's mandatory, as I said previously, that you should have a higher score. So because these higher score candidates will be shortlisted and these shortlisted candidates will be getting into the interview. And the remaining will not get into the interview. And even interview, again, by checking your personality skills, your communication skills, your creativity skills, or your body language, the way you speak, the way you communicate, everything they'll check, followed by your document verifications and which your educational aggregations and everything. Then only you'll be again refiltered and getting into the job. So this is how the selection procedure will be. So maximum the candidates will be passing in the written examination, but they may score, they may not score a good selective thing in your interview. So it's mandatory that you have to appear for both in a very perfect and well perfect manner. Now coming to the application fees for unreserved categories, other backward classes candidates, it is 150 rupees along with your processing charge of rupees 50 and challan rupees of 20. Then followed by schedule caste, schedule type, physically handicapped persons, only processing charge will be provided or like you have to submit. It is of 50 rupees and challan rupees is 20. So as soon as you fill your application form details, you will get a fee payment option. So following that option, you can pay your fees with any of the availabilities like net banking or the credit card or the debit card method through an online method. Now, how do you apply for this application form? So when you get into the online website of this notification, some instructions will be provided. You have to check all the instructions thoroughly. If you're agreeing with those terms and conditions, then start filling your details, submit your passport size photos of 2 or 3 copies, followed by your educational qualification certificates and even your ID proof. So ID proof comes like your Aadhaar card or the PAN card or the voter ID, just to verify the details that you have provided in your application forms are varying with ID proof or not. Then, educational qualification comes like as it is an 8th standard qualification. Make sure if you are completing 8th standard, you will submit your 8th class certificate. But whatever you submit, you have to scan it and upload it as a soft copy or the attachment file for your application form. Then submit it, then print out this application form for further use. So this is how you have to apply. Now coming to the important dates, the starting date of application form is 6th March 2020 and the last date of application form is 7th April 2020. So make sure that you all apply before the last date, that is April 7th, because by this date application forms will be closed completely through the online. So I hope you all got the details right. If you have any queries rather than these, you can follow the link that we provide in our video description. So friends, this is all about today's job notification. I will be coming up with new job notifications for you all. If you like this video, please raise your thumbs up, share and comment. Thank you for watching.